In this video, you'll learn everything you probably need to know about decibels. But if you're new here, welcome. My name is Kyle. If you want to learn audio production online, subscribe to Audio University. The decibel is one of the most confusing concepts in audio production. Trying to wrap your mind around every detail all at once might leave you feeling overwhelmed. The truth is, for most people, learning a few key principles about the decibel will be sufficient for working in the audio industry. The first thing you should know is that decibels can represent large ratios using simple numbers. That's one reason the decibel is so useful for describing sound pressure. Humans are capable of perceiving a vast range of sound pressure, from very subtle to very extreme. Discussing sound pressure in absolute units can be challenging. The Pascal is an absolute unit of measurement that describes air pressure in terms of force per square meter. The limits of human perception of sound pressure range from 20 micropascals to 20 pascals, a ratio of 1 to 10 million. It's much easier to discuss sound pressure in terms of decibels. This chart shows a side-by-side comparison of the two. You can see sound pressure in pascals on the left and sound pressure level in decibels on the right. Decibels present these quantities in a way that is much easier for us to interpret. In audio production, the decibel is also useful because it presents sound pressure on a scale that's much more relevant to the way humans perceive loudness. Most of us are accustomed to thinking in linear terms. For instance, twice as many letters produce a word that's twice as long. This mode of thinking, however, does not hold true for the way humans perceive loudness. Thinking in linear terms, you might suspect that twice the amplifier power produces a sound that's twice as loud. This is not the case. The way humans perceive loudness is more similar to a logarithmic scale than a linear scale. In a linear scale, each step is the same size. For example, 10, 20, 30, 40, where each step is an addition of 10. In a logarithmic scale, each step has the same proportion. 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000, where each step is multiplied by 10. As sound pressure increases, more and more power is required to create the same perceived increase in loudness. The decibel accounts for this fact by presenting absolute units on a scale that better relates to human hearing. A decibel is a way of describing the ratio between two quantities. Saying the drums are 120 dB is an incomplete statement. That's because the decibel alone has no value. It's only when you draw a comparison to something else that the decibel has meaning. You could instead say, the drums are 20 dB louder than the guitar. And this statement is more meaningful because it draws a comparison between the level of the drums and the level of the guitar. The level of the guitar in this case is the 0 dB reference point. In the case of a fader on a mixing console, unity gain is the 0 dB reference point. Pushing the fader above 0 dB adds gain to the signal. Pulling the fader below 0 dB attenuates or reduces the signal. Decibel values above unity are represented by positive numbers, and decibel values below unity are represented by negative numbers. For many applications in audio production, there are standardized reference points that define 0 dB in absolute terms. Each application has its own suffix: dBm, dBu, dBspl, etc. Here is a helpful chart that defines the 0 dB reference point in common audio applications. This chart brings meaning to the various types of decibels. The formula for decibel calculations will make a lot more sense if you first understand the relationship between decibels and bells. This is the formula for finding the ratio between two power quantities in bells. Power 1 is the reference power, and power 2 is the measured power. Let's try finding the ratio in bells between 10 watts and 100 watts. The formula would look like this. Dividing 100 by 10 gives us the ratio between the power quantities, which is 10. Using the log function of the calculator, we can find that the log of 10 is 1. Therefore, the ratio between 10 watts and 100 watts is 1 bell. Now that you've learned the formula for calculating ratios in bells, let's take a look at how to adjust that formula to calculate ratios in decibels. A decibel is 1/10 of a bell. For comparison's sake, let's use the same power quantities we used before, 10 watts and 100 watts, this time finding the ratio in decibels. To start, divide 100 by 10 to find the ratio, which is 10. Use a calculator to find the log of 10, which is 1. Multiply 1 by 10 to convert bells to decibels. The ratio between 10 watts and 100 watts is 10 decibels, or 1 bell. For many, the most confusing aspect of the decibel is deciding which formula to use in a given situation. The formula for decibels is 10 times the log of power 2 over power 1. In some situations, however, you might see this formula: 20 times the log of value 2 over value 1. Why are different formulas used, and how do you choose which formula is appropriate in a given situation? The decibel is a power-related ratio. When finding the ratio between two quantities of acoustical power or electrical power, use the basic formula we learned in the last section. The decibel can be used to represent the ratio between non-power quantities, such as sound pressure and voltage. When calculating voltage and sound pressure levels, use this formula. The reason we multiply by 20 is explained by the power equation. In this equation, W is power, E is voltage, and R is resistance. Notice that voltage is squared in this equation. Power is proportional to voltage squared. Quantities that are not power must be made proportional to power. Another way to come to the same answer would be to use this formula, squaring each voltage value before finding the ratio. Anytime you're comparing power quantities in decibels, multiply the bell formula by 10. Anytime you're comparing non-power quantities in decibels, multiply the bell formula by 20. It's hard to get a straight answer when asking someone how many decibels is a doubling. Well, that's because it depends on what's being doubled. As you just learned, non-power quantities must be made proportional to power in order to be represented in decibels. Following that logic, the decibel value used to describe a doubling in a power quantity is different from the decibel value used to describe a doubling of a non-power quantity. It's helpful to remember the decibel value for representing a 2-to-1 and 10-to-1 change in power, voltage, and sound pressure level. Use this chart for reference. Everything discussed in this video can be found in the post I wrote on audiouniversityonline.com. I'll put a link to that post in the description of this video. If you got value out of this video, hit the like button, share the video, and subscribe to Audio University. Thanks for watching.